So you're probably thinking, okay, great, I'm going to make an organic banana house, but how do I make it popular, Claude? I think the first step is to just figure out what you like. Figure out all the stuff that you like. Try to start making it. Try to be original. Try to make some cool ass sounds that nobody's made, or just really good stuff that you really enjoy to listen to. And the more you keep making great music and finding places to release it, the better you're going to do. You know, everybody thinks that everybody sees everything they're doing right when they're doing it. But guess what? There's like 80 billion people. So if I put out a song, there's a good chance that no one is going to hear that song for maybe even 2 years. They might not hear it. To assume that everybody knows that your song came out the day it came out is insanity. Like, that's not true. There's no way. Nobody's like monitoring the internet to see what you're doing every day. Even famous people. Well, some people are. People are monitoring to see what Rihanna's doing, I think. But besides her, nobody is really monitoring to see what I'm doing every day, I don't think. So you got to just keep believing, because eventually people are going to hear the music. And you consistently keep putting it out and keep pushing it and keep doing your thing and keep making friends on the internet or in real life that are also into your thing. When you get a friend group that really helps you get it out there and get a base and a whole bunch of people talking about something. If you can't find somebody to release your music, just put it on SoundCloud, put it on Mixcloud, put it on free sites where people can get music, or start your own label. Starting your own label, don't do it half-ass. So I have a whole other video about starting your label. Don't do a half-ass label. I've found cool music on SoundCloud, especially bass music and other kinds of weird stuff. You can get your music out there and just promote it the best way you can. There's probably a bunch of people out there that are like, man, I gotta learn Ableton, and then I gotta get like these super like polished beats going, and like I gotta get them over, get this like super high-end singer, and like we gotta get in the commercial dance charts. And I'm like, yeah, but what do you really want to do? What I'm really trying to say is, you don't have to be cheesy if you don't want to. And people who like cheesy music are not necessarily cheesy because they like it. So I can't even, nobody, theoretically, then no one is cheesy. Except for the people who make cheese. Do they live in Wisconsin? I don't know. I'm getting down the wormhole, the philosophical wormhole. But just do what you really want to do. The chances of you succeeding are way higher also if you do exactly what you want to do, because you're going to be into it, and you're going to be into it for a long time, and you're not going to be making license plates over at the major label and kissing everyone's ass in all these meetings and whatever you got to go to. This is just my impression of what a major label is like inside. I don't even know. But... I'm like, make a hit, we make hits every day. I'm just kidding. It's like the Oompa Loompas. But I don't know. I'm just saying, I just live here. You know what I'm saying? I just want everybody to be themselves. You might be having 3 jobs and like just trying to keep it together. But even if that's the case, you should do the sound that you want, because that's going to help your brain. You need that release. Music helps everybody. Music helps your heart. It helps your brain. Listening to music is great. Making music is great. Music is great. Don't do stupid music that you don't want to do, okay? You don't have to make commercial music to make it. If you love commercial music and you want to be commercial, I still love you, baby, but you don't have to do that if you don't want to.